Hello, DIY techies. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and you are watching DIY in 5. Today, we're speaking Android. More specifically, how to choose the right microSD card for your Android device. We showed you how to free up storage space in your existing phone on another DIY, but what if you want to add more storage to it? There are a few things to look out for when picking up that microSD for your favorite robot OS device. First things first, make sure you're one of the many lucky Android owners whose device has a microSD slot. Sometimes they're located underneath your battery cover, with your SIM card, or it might have its own slot. Check out your phone or tablet's user guide if you're not sure where to look or you can't find it. The next thing you need to know is what capacity cards your Android supports. For example, the Samsung Galaxy S7 phones can take cards up to 200 gigabytes, but the 2015 Moto G can only handle 32 gigabyte cards. Make sure you check your user manual or just Google that shiz so you don't get more storage than your phone can handle. Now that you know the largest capacity card your Android supports, ask yourself how much you really need. Bigger doesn't necessarily mean better, it all depends on how you use it. Are you a movie watcher who downloads films before a flight, or do you have large apps and games that take up all of your built-in storage? You might only need another 16 or 32 gigabytes of storage to get you the extra space you need. Or are you an amateur photographer who records every single moment and snaps away the day capturing everything you see? If that's the case, you might want to get a 64 gigabyte card or higher to keep up with all those shots. See the link to the capacity chart in the description below. It can help you establish how many photos and videos you can hold on each card. Something you might not have considered is the speed of a card. With phones now capable of shooting video in 4K and burst mode photography, speed is something you should keep in mind. If you're an amateur photographer capturing your entire day, you might want to get a card with a rating of UHS 1 Class 3. These cards have speeds of at least 30 megabytes per second and can keep up with your phone's camera. But if you're just adding some extra storage to watch a few movies and store extra apps, then a Class 10 or UHS 1 Class 1 card should do just fine. As the Lady of Light Galadriel once said, "Even the smallest SD card can change the course of your device's history." That's the exact quote, I'm pretty sure. Please comment below if you have tips you want to share, and be sure to subscribe for more everyday tech tips and videos. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and thank you for watching this episode of DIY in 5.